Hello and welcome dear children. Today we will study Standard 7th English, Chapter number 1.4, The King's Choice. This will be the part 1 of the lesson. Children, you must have heard of various folk tales, isn't it? So the King's Choice is also a folk tale. Children, can you name some of the animals that live in a forest? Yeah. We see so many animals, elephants, giraffes, tigers, lions, and many more. And do you know who is the king of the forest? Yeah, we all know that lion is the king of the forest. We can also say king of the jungle. Why is he called king? Yes, because it is very strong, very fierce, and all the other animals are very weak in front of him. So he is the strongest animal in the forest. So he has taken over as a king in the forest. All the other animals have to listen to him. Let's begin with the lesson now. The King's Choice is a story that takes us to a forest where the Lion King appoints the fox, the vulture, and the leopard as his courtiers. Every creature has some unique quality in them. What are the qualities of fox? Yes, he is clever and smart. We have heard so many stories about, you know, the clever fox and all. So yes, we all know fox is very clever animal. The next we see over here is the leopard. How is the leopard? Yeah, it is very swift. It's very fast. The next animal we have, that is vulture. Vulture is in fact a bird, right? It can fly very high in the sky. Okay, so these are the different qualities that these animals that we are going to see in the story, they have in them. Okay, and one more is there, that is camel. Children, do you know about the camel? Yes, it is called as the ship of the desert. Why? Because they can carry very big loads from one side of the desert to the other. They can walk 4 kilometers per hour through the hot desert. They can go like this for 3 weeks without water. So you see, these are the different qualities that every animal in the story is having. So let's see what the king of the jungle, that is the lion, has decided. Chapter number 1.4, The King's Choice. There was once a lion who was king of the forest. He was big and strong and very fierce. Now, what do you mean by fierce, children? I told you last time. Yes, fierce means very frightening, very strong, very scary also. So all the other animals in the forest called him king. They brought him gifts from every corner of the forest. And what do you think the gifts must be? Yes, the food, isn't it? The lion is very, you know, huge animal, and it needs lots of food so that it becomes more and more strong. But the more the lion had, the more he wanted. So whatever food they brought from every corner of the forest was not enough for him. He went on eating more and more and growing more fierce, more stronger. A king must have a court, he said to himself one day. Children, do you know what is a court? Yes, we have heard, we have seen, we have read various stories where a king is there along with his ministers in his court. Okay, why does he need so many ministers? You can say there is one minister as a finance minister who will look about the accounts and the financial status of the kingdom. Then the other we can say is, you know, a health minister. Okay, so we'll look after the health of the people of his kingdom. one, we need an advisor. Like that, there are many ministers in the court of a king. So a king needs ministers in his court. So here, even the lion decides to have ministers with him. Okay, so let's see whom does he go and approach. We all know fox. First he goes to the fox. Okay, why? Because a fox is a wise and a clever creature. Okay, and because of, you know, his wiseness and his cleverness, he can be taken up as an advisor in his court. Next he goes and approaches whom? A leopard. If you see leopards are very watchful, they are very smart, like, you know, CCTV cameras, they can watch very carefully, clearly, and they are very swift also, they are very fast. So a leopard can become his bodyguard. Okay, and next he approaches to the vulture. Vulture is in fact a bird, we all know, and it can fly very high in the sky. So a vulture can be his messengers because he can fly very high. I'll just read this part for you. He called a fox to his side. "You are known to be a wise and clever creature, fox," said the lion. "I want you to be my advisor." "Thank you, your majesty," said the fox, bowing low. See, with respect, the fox accepts his, you know, whatever task the king has given him. The lion next called a leopard to his side. "You are known to be watchful and swift of foot, leopard. I want you to be my bodyguard." "Thank you, your majesty," said the leopard, bowing low. The lion then called a vulture to his side. "You are a bird, vulture, and can fly high. You are to be my messenger." "Thank you, your majesty," said the vulture, bowing low. The fox, the vulture, and the leopard took an oath. Now, what is oath, children? See, when you take up any challenge, any responsibility, you have to promise yourself that whatever job you have got, you are going to do it very loyally and very, you know, wholeheartedly. You must have seen when the ministers are appointed, the ministers of our India, okay, or you can take Prime Minister, Health Minister. So there is an oath ceremony where, you know, they promise in front of the whole nation. It goes on live on the television also. So we can see that what promise the leader of a nation is going to give us. So they take an oath, a promise, okay? And, you know, they have to be true to their promise. They have to follow what they say, okay? So all the three take an oath of loyalty. Okay, the king promised to give them food and protection. So if they are working for the king, what is the king going to give them in return? Yes, he's going to give them food and also protection. Why protection? Because the other animals are there in the forest, no? They can harm fox, vulture, or leopard. They can harm. So a king will always be there to protect them. So he offered him food and he offered him protection. For some time, all went well in the court of the Lion King. The three courtiers never opposed the king. His wishes were law. Means what? Whatever he wished, whatever he felt, oh, I would like this. I would like to have so and so things. So whatever he wished, it was like a law for them. Okay, this our king wants. Yes, we are going to get that for him. So whenever he roared, they stood in awe. What is the meaning of awe over here now? Awe means what? They stood in awe means they stood in respect with due fear. Okay, so whenever he took a walk, they followed him. When the Lion King went hunting, they found the animals for him to kill. And after he had his meal, he left the remains for them, so they always had enough to eat. So you see, these courtiers used to go in the forest hunting animals for the Lion King. And when the lion used to have his food enough, his stomach was full, that time the remains were left for the courtiers, that is the leopard, fox and the vulture. So they also used to have enough food, okay? So I hope children, whatever I have explained today, you all have understood. The next part of the lesson will continue in the part 2 of our video.